Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 18th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1110.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the 23rd time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 2 is in terminal guidance.
Landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Also on Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 19th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1218.
1, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1077, then landed successfully for the 18th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
2, terminal guidance.
Stage 1, landing leg deploy. Stage 1, landing confirmed.
Then yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 20th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 12-8.
1, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1067, then became the first booster to land for a 26th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors.
Landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
SpaceX posted about this lost Falcon landing. They said Falcon 9 lands on the A Shortfall of Gravitors drone ship, completing the first 26th launch and landing of an orbital class rocket. This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a few Falcon missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 1012 mission, is currently scheduled for Tuesday 18th at 11:15 PM UTC or 6:15 PM EST. A couple of days later and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 15-1 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 20th at 12:01 AM UTC or Wednesday 19th at 7:01 PM EST. Then, a day after that and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 12-4 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 21st at 11:31 AM UTC or 6:31 AM EST. SpaceX have obtained a new launch from NASA for a satellite mission. This article says NASA has selected SpaceX of Starbase, Texas to provide the launch service for the agency's Pandora mission, which will study at least 20 known exoplanets and their host stars to find out how changes in stars affect our observations of exoplanet atmospheres. Heading to Boca Chica, work is continuing with the Pad B launch site. Loads of work has been continuing at the orbital tank farm. Work has also been continuing at the orbital Pad A launch site. In response to a post about an official document on the matter, Musk posted some Starbase information. He said Starbase Texas will soon be an official new city. There was some information posted about SpaceX's water deluge permit. It says TSEC has approved SpaceX's Starbase deluge water permit after thorough analysis and finding of no significant impact discussed in today's hearing. Here's Test Tank 16 in the jig for Starship catch testing at Massey's. Ship 32 scrapping has been continuing with this section scene moved out of the high bay. Recently, Starship 34 was rolled to Massey's test site for static fire testing. SpaceX posted this video of a static fire of Starship 34 as they prepare for Starship Flight 8. They said Starship long duration static fire ahead of the 8th flight test. They responded to this post and said the extended firing tested new hardware and cycled the six Raptor engines through multiple thrust levels to recreate different conditions seen within the propulsion system during flight. Data from the test will inform upgrades to the ship's hardware and flight profile ahead of the next launch. After static fire testing, Starship 34 was moved back to the production site. The nose cone for Starship 36 was recently seen moved into Mega Bay 2. Recently, Booster 15 performed a static fire test in preparation for Flight 8. SpaceX posted some pictures of this static fire testing and said full duration static fire test of Super Heavy. After the static fire testing, Booster 15 was removed from the launch mount. Booster 15 was then rolled back to the production site for final pre-launch work. This Booster 17 aft section was spotted in the yard and later moved into Mega Bay 1. There was also a forward section for Booster 17 moved into Mega Bay 1. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.